For a periodic look at interesting people and ideas online that you may have missed on the web, a segment we call Not Trending. I recorded this conversation recently. There were several stories that caught our eye on the website Ozzy recently, including ones focused on some intriguing efforts with public education and matters of justice. Carlos Watson is the founder and CEO of Ozzy and, as always, joins me now.
Good to be with you.
I want to start by asking you about this gentleman, Antoine Wilson. He's the superintendent of schools in Oakland, California, not a job for the faint of heart. In fact, he spends a lot of his time dodging spitballs.
Sadly, but seriously, death threats, a lot of anger. Oakland, as you know, has been a place of protest for many years. They've never been afraid to protest. And when it comes to public education, which has not been good there, they've got a new superintendent, Antoine, comes from Denver and is trying to change things in a fairly dramatic way.
What does he have to change? It seems like he's got everything that comes all together in this one municipality, whether it's debates about Common Core or violence or academic standards for young black men.
All in one place, and unfortunately a 67% high school graduation rate, whereas in much of the country it's in the 80s and the 90s, so really difficult. He's trying to tackle this in a couple of ways. One, he says the most important thing is who's in the school buildings, who are the teachers, who's the principals. It's been a little bit of a tough fight to try and hire different people. He's had to increase salaries, but he's also asked for more flexibility in saying yes and no to people. The charter school conversation, you've heard how difficult that's become. He actually has said, you know what, we can coexist. Some of the public school superintendents have tried to push him aside. That's been something he's been open to. Trying to reduce class sizes in some ways, so trying to bring back that conversation, going from 30 students in a class sometimes down to 24 or 25.
The fight is often left versus right when we talk about education in this country. In Oakland, it's left versus left.
You know, you are 100% right, and what a terrific and great way to say it. No, the protests are serious. If you go to one of the school board meetings, people would argue that he's not doing enough. So in some places, as you've said before, left versus right, left versus super left in Oakland. What's interesting about Antoine Wilson also to follow is he's one of the last reform superintendents. You remember when Michelle Rhee was such a big name?
Mm-hmm.
Now they're very
here in Washington, D.C.
Very few names across the country like that who've got that kind of compelling reform agenda. He's one of the last, one of the few black men.
Let's talk about something uplifting, even though it starts in a bad place. And that's in a prison in Arizona. And it's an effort, an interesting effort, and something that certainly isn't trending to kind of transform the lives of inmates.
Very much so. So you know today in the U.S., we've got north of 2 million people in prison. Almost half of them, when they leave prison, end up back in prison within a few years. And so a number of folks have said, is there a different way forward? And one of them is having some of the prisoners work with wild horses. So in the West, places like Arizona, over 40,000 kind of wild Mustangs. Bureau of Land Management said, let's take these horses in, let's try and tame them, and in some cases, let's sell them or give them to others, including even working for the U.S. government. And now they've got a couple dozen prisoners who are working for 4 to 6 months at a time, day in and day out, not making a lot, but maybe learning a little bit.
Is there any evidence that this kind of effort to deter recidivism actually takes hold, that once they connect with these wild horses, these wild animals, that perhaps they see a different purpose?
There is. So, before it started in Arizona, you saw it in Colorado, and so it's been around for 20-plus years, and the recidivism rate, the number of people who end up back in jail within 3 to 5 years, has been down to 15%. In some of those cases versus 50% plus. So it can have dramatic impacts. Now this program's new, it's only been around a year and a half. They're working with a couple of dozen horses. But one of the things that Randy Helm, the guy who runs it, says is people have to learn that bad decisions are hard and good decisions are easy. And that doing that with the horses, in some cases, they hope, can teach that to some of the prisoners as well.
On that optimistic note, we're talking about things not trending, as always, with Carlos Watson.
Always good to be with you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You can find more of my conversation with Carlos online. A look at the president of a small African nation called the Gambia. He rules a regime increasingly criticized for human rights abuses with an iron fist. That's at pbs.org/newshour.